Hey guys, welcome to Talk to Me Tuesday. It's Tuesday, February 17th, 2015. This is Jennifer. For those of you that aren't aware, I was not here last week because we had another death in our family on the 9th of February, which was last Monday, and I could not face a video on Tuesday. It's actually pretty hard for me to be here today, but I am going to be here because the person that we lost was my mother-in-law, Carol, and she would not have wanted me to mope around and not do things and not get on with my life, because that was how she tackled the world. She was a really gung-ho, in-your-face, get-it-done kind of girl, and that is what I want to think about while I'm trying to move forward and while my family is trying to move forward. She was the first parent that we've lost, and she was the first grandparent that my kids lost, and so it's been very hard, and it's just been a very trying year this year. You guys probably remember that I lost my grandmother just a few weeks ago, and it's just been kind of one thing after another and very, very stressful. But we're gonna move forward, and we are gonna do good, and we are gonna do what we do, and we're gonna get through this. I've had some people ask me if there's anything they can do or any way they can remember her, and if that is something you're interested in, the family has asked for donations to the Alpine, Texas Public Library. I will put a link in the description. And if that is a thing that you would like to do in memory of Carol Ofenstein, please do it. That would be lovely. And I thank you for that, because books were extremely close to her heart. She was also a crafter. She knitted, she sewed, she made beautiful stained glass, which I did a post about last week on sewhook.com. And on top of all of that, she was also county treasurer for Brewster County, Texas, and she did all kinds of other things. She was a very, very, very dynamic and busy and amazing person. So I have a few things to share. It's actually taken me a little bit to get my head together and remember what I'm supposed to be sharing today. First, Linus is this weekend, and QuiltCon is also in Austin. So if you happen to be in Austin for QuiltCon, and you are not busy at 9 a.m. on Saturday morning and would like to meet me or see the Linus connection, I would love for you to come by St. Philip's in Round Rock. It's off Highway 620. I can put a link in the description for that, or you can just go to thelinusconnection.org, and we have information about where we meet. We meet from 9 to 11 on Saturday, and I am almost always there. I will definitely be here this weekend. If I ever needed a Linus meeting, this is probably it. And in the vein of meeting for Linus, this Frogger quilt is done. I actually finished it, I don't even know, week and a half ago, something like that. I had it ready to show you guys last week, but like I said, no video last week. I had so much fun working on this. This center part with just Frogger, this is a free pattern you can find on Sewhook or Fandom and Stitches. I did this last year for the Make It Mosaic event we did on Fandom and Stitches. So Frogger was actually my favorite video game when I was a kid, because we didn't go to arcades very much, and I am of the pre-everyone having a video game at home generation, and so Frogger was one of the games that was available to play, and I only got a couple bucks to play, so I always played the same game because that's just how my brain works. I wanted to be good at one thing even if I, you know, didn't get to try all the other games. So Frogger was my game. I quilted swirls with the variegated blue in the background of this, and I also did swirls with green in this border and swirls again in the outside ends. And this is one of my favorite fabrics to use for binding on bright colored quilts. This is actually just a really inexpensive fabric from Joann's. It's 100% cotton. It washes up great, but it's just this fantastic rainbow stripe that makes a quilt like this just a little extra fun. For Frogger himself, I actually went around the whole of Frogger. It was all straight line quilting, and then I just grid quilted the rest of the little squares so that it actually, the mosaic really shows up. But I did get it finished, and it washed up fine, and all this needs is a paper tag that has the Linus poem and information on it, and then that goes out to the Linus connection. I started a quilt for my sister. She does not have a Harry Potter quilt from me. She has a rag quilt that I made her many years ago before I really got into paper piecing, and so I am making her a Project of Doom, and this is the first block for her quilt. This background fabric is this fantastic lavender, And I'm going to do my best to make all of the items in her quilt really pop. So I will be working on my sister's quilt during the 2015 Project of Doom quilt along. This tree block up here is my tree at sunset, blown up to 12 inches. This was a challenge for the Blue Bonnet Shop Hop that is this year. It's a Central Texas shop hop that happens every year, and they always do a challenge for a local charity. So they collect 12 inch blocks. There's a challenge fabric. You make whatever you want, whatever technique you want, and then those all go to a charity. I'm not actually submitting mine for the challenge itself, but I know the lady who is receiving all these blocks for her charity this year, and she makes blankets for children's hospitals in Rwanda, and so that will go to her charity, and it was just a fun block to make. The challenge fabric was actually this K facet, and that's what I used to make the tree. I received numerous things in the mail last week that I'm not going to show you today because I just haven't been able to go through all of it yet. So if you've sent me something and I haven't responded or said anything about it, please know that I have it and I will get to it. Also, I received a bag back from my friend Marge, who does a lot of the quilting for the Linus Connection, and she had some quilts that were quilt tops that had been sent to me, and these just need binding, and if I have time before Saturday, I will get all these bound and they will go out to Linus, and I just wanted to show those to you really quick. You may remember the tree quilt that I did recently. I'm just going to show you a little bit of it here. This guy was pieced on the diagonal, and Marge quilted this for me. It's got a nice big meander on it. This was given to me in strips. It was almost completely done. I just added a little bit, like you can see this corner here is a slightly different fabric from the other background. It's really even hard to tell in the video. I just added a couple pieces, sewed all the rows together, added this flannel border, and then Marge got it all quilted, and I just need to put a binding on it for Linus. I have three quilts that were from quilt tops that Lenora sent me, and I want to show those really quick. So this was from Lenora, and Marge quilted this, so you can see that. So Lenora, I do have your other box, and I do thank you for everything you've sent. I haven't had a chance to go through it yet, but I will go through it this week. And I will take pictures of all of these. And if I don't put them on So Hooked, they will definitely be in my Flickr, which on Flickr, you can just search for my name and you'll find me. I have another quilt that was donated by Lenora, and this one is just really happy fabrics with some 9 patches in the middle. And you can see, again, I'm trying to get the light to hit it correctly, you can see the meander again. And I have this one last one also from Lenora, and it is also Marge's signature meander. It's just a really nice big, can you see it? Yes. This one, it just needs a binding. All of these that I just showed you just need a binding, and Marge even provided me with fabric that coordinates for all of these if they didn't already have it with them. I've also been doing a little bit of hand stitching. I have a new design that is an old design that was supposed to be a paper piece pattern that I actually never finished, and I redrafted it as an embroidery design. And as soon as I finish that, I will share that with you guys. It's going to be a freebie for Fandom and Stitches. And pretty much that's it. My brain has been going in 6,000 directions. And this week, my goal is just to get some normalcy back in my days. I think that's it. I do have other things to share, but I'm going to save them when I'm a little more coherent and can explain things a little better. And I do hope you guys are doing well. I hope whatever you're working on that you can share on Talk to Me Tuesday, because as you know, there are prizes in February. I believe Snowy44 is our prize giver in February for sharing your videos on ttmt.livejournal.com. Join us tomorrow on Fandom and Stitches for week 7 of Project of Doom Quilt Along 2015. Also, be sure and check out Zazzle. We have Project of Doom t-shirts and coffee mugs and tote bags. We have new Fandom and Stitches merch that is, I have a new design that I did last week that just I'm in love with. I have to get one for myself. It says My Fandom is Stitching, and it's a Fandom and Stitches t-shirt. And so you can search Fandom and Stitches, or you can go to thefandomandstitches.com. And in the sidebar, there's a link that says Support Fandom and Stitches. If you go there, all of our links to anything that we have, Zazzle, we're an Audible affiliate and other things like that. It's all on the one page. And okay, I'm done. I've looked around my room and there's nothing else. So there's nothing else pressing anyway. So I am done and I hope to hear from you guys and I will see you next week. Bye.